The authorization for Poland's farmers to use neonicotinoids came as an unpleasant surprise to beekeeper Lukasz Kusznik.
Byłem zaszokowany I zaskoczony ze względu na to, że myślałem, że ten temat już jest zakończony.
I was shocked and surprised because I thought that this issue was already dealt with, that after long discussions in the European Union, neonicotinoids were banned. I was also surprised by the reason that due to drought and crop failure, they are to be approved, mainly for rapeseed. I hope that it will somehow be removed and carefully thought out.
The approval to use the banned chemicals was granted in response to a request by Poland's National Association of Rapeseed and Protein Plant Producers, which warned of an emergency situation for the country's rapeseed crop due to adverse weather. The ministry is allowing their use for up to 120 days. But that presents an emergency situation for beekeepers.
We have a highly virulent disease, the parasite varroa, which can decimate beehives with inadequate management of the apiary. There are also a number of viruses that attack bees, and these chemicals will further worsen their situation.
In nearby Katowice, biologists at the University of Silesia caution that even temporary exposure to the chemicals could disrupt bees' communication and feeding and could kill them.
An insect that is treated with a neonicotinoid has a shock. It is paralyzed due to a continuous flow of current through its nerve cells, which of course leads to its death. The important thing is that chronic toxicity or long-term exposure to a pesticide, even at doses that do not cause death, can lead to very many complications for bees at the level of the entire swarm.
Poland's emergency approval of neonicotinoid-containing chemicals is not an isolated case. According to the European Food Safety Authority, 7 EU members across the bloc granted similar authorizations in 2017. The use of neonicotinoids in the European Union has been restricted to certain crops since 2013, but environmental groups have called for a total ban and sparked a debate across the continent about the wider use of chemicals in farming. Julie Taboh, VOA News.